lots of people to thank, but I'm not going to bore you with that right at the moment. We'll take care of most of those thank yous at the end of the performance this evening. But first and foremost, I want to thank all of you for not only supporting our young stars tonight, but throughout the last 4 weeks, getting them here every morning, picking them up afterwards. We thank you so much. I know how much that is. So thank you so much for all your support. Let me applaud you. Thank you very much. And before we get started, I think I'm going to introduce one of our teachers who's been teaching here now for, what, 30 years?
About 30.
This is Johnny B. Johnny, it's yours.
Hello, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to Ritz TV, a show that was created and performed by all of your little friends, neighbors, childrens, and cousins. This is a show that has been in the makings for about 4 weeks now. We started our camp with 2 weeks of activities and games, giving them the foundation and building blocks they need to get to where they are today. The last 2 weeks were all about the conception and completion of what you see before you. And this is pretty impressive, I must say. Congratulations to our campers. All right, so before we get started, I wanted to give you an example of something that we like to do, about five times a week or so. It's a little game we like to call Hitchhiker. Girls! Hooray for the young ladies coming out. In the game Hitchhiker, there are four people that participate. One is the driver. Fabulous. There are two passengers, and there is one hitchhiker. Very nice. Now, this is a game that's based completely on improvisation. So what I'm going to do in a little bit, so turn your thinking caps on, I'm going to ask four people for four different personalities for these poor young actors. What's going to happen is in this car, this is the car, a very triangular car, they're going to set up their characters, they're going to pick a destination, and then along that trail, they're going to find a hitchhiker who's going to come in, and a lot of the time, she tosses them a curveball. So, let's get started here. I want some volunteers. Who can give me a personality for our driver? Raise your hand. We've all been in school before. Don't be shy. Hand raise. Yes, sir. A diva, that's gonna be tough. All right. How about for this lovely passenger, yes? A foreigner, all right, good. You're as the whack bell. All right, good, foreigner. Having trouble with this language. Another one, yes, I see a hand. A dancer, I like that, work on the grace. And our hitchhiker, yes? A superstar, so maybe you wanna pick somebody specific, right? Okay, so people in the car, we're gonna pick a destination, our relationship, and we're gonna show our characters very clearly. Think for 3 seconds. One, two, three. And action.
Do you guys know that hamburgers are like so disgusting at McDonald's?
It's hard to stretch in here.
Do you know McDonald's is like really fat? Hey, Miss Dancer. You're not the star of the car. I am! Okay, then. Guys, we're not going to McDonald's, okay? McDonald's is too overfat. We need to go to some French restaurant.
Don't eat McDonald's.
Do you think we could drive to France?
We,
You guys, like, are not the stars of my car. I'm the star of my own car, okay? So, chill.
I'm the star of everyone's car.
Chill.
You're very upsetting.
Why, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm only here because my chauffeur quit on me. Well, why do you think I was going to be your chauffeur? Yeah, I said it.
What are you doing?
I'm stretching.
all that, but she's really not.
I'm a dancer.
Whatever. Wait, why do I have her in my car? I don't even know who she is.
No one knows who she is. I don't think she knows what you're talking about.
She doesn't know anything about divas or like that. Like, she needs to get one of those like chauffeurs and red carpet premieres. Don't touch me, I'm famous. I told you before, don't touch me, I'm famous.
She doesn't speak our language, okay?
Don't touch her. Don't touch me.
Here comes a tree.
Oh my God.
Congratulations. Gotta love them. All right, so sit back, relax, and a few other cliches, and please enjoy the show.
The deodorant for sweaty Danish philosophers. Here are anchor persons Morgan McCleary and Hannah Fields.
Good evening, I'm Morgan McCleary.
And I'm Hannah Fields. Before we start, I'd like to respond to some mail that we've received. Many of you have explained that my co-anchor and I act in less than a professional manner. Well, never again will you see me lose my dignity by overreacting to any of my fellow correspondents. No matter how feeble they may be.
And I can guarantee each and every
That's
one of you that I will never again call my co-anchor names like idiot, brainless, or even useless, even if they are. That's a promise.
Well, isn't that cute? Someone taught a bag of hair how to talk. Lovely.
On our top story, supervillain Lady Gaga brazenly abducted Commissioner James Gordon from a charity fundraiser Tuesday, leaving police baffled and citizens of Gotham fearing for their safety. Known for her outlandish costumes and geometric polygon hair, the criminal madwoman made a daring escape from Arkham Asylum last week and has been taunting authorities by interrupting broadcasts ever since. Quote, if you ever want to see Commissioner Gordon again, you'll do exactly as I say. End quote, Lady Gaga said from her secret lair, adjusting her yellow tie back and spandex dress as henchmen danced menacingly around the bound commissioner. While the kidnapping occurred at Stately Wayne Manor, home of the Playboy jet setter Bruce Wayne, the eccentric billionaire was not available for comment.
And in sports, Hall of Famer Yogi Berra expressed frustration and disappointment during a press conference Monday, asking why the Yankees organization had made no effort to mourn his death in 2006. I've given a lot to this team, and yet they haven't done a single thing to honor me or show me their grief, said the visibly distressed 85-year-old. I died over 3 years ago and didn't even get a stinking moment of silence. Well, you know what they say about death? They don't say it. Barrett added that at the very minimum, the Yankees should have let him address the crowd to say goodbye one last time.
That story was almost as lame as your love life, Hannah. We'll be right back after this brief commercial message.
It's Sesame Street in the backyard. All the fun and imagination of Sesame Street is here, but thanks to Slide On, Wriggle Through, Pretend to Talk With, and Play With, the outdoors is even more fun when Sesame Street is a part of it. There's enough Sesame Street for everyone's backyard. It's fun, from and to, each sold separately.
Vibrant coloring of the spring and vivid rich details. Cruise city sounds below the arrows. Orbit's filter entertainment at your fingertips. Call 1-800-OK. Digital connection for $9.95 connection only. Gaming cable offers new features on demand, order in an instant, and pause, rewind, fast forward with no contract to buy and no equipment.
I want to watch MTV.
And welcome back to the MTV Music Video Awards. We're down to our final category, Best Video of All Time. In one corner we have Team Gavin, and in the other corner we have Team Julia. Text your votes to 555-MUSIC and our winners will be announced at the end of the song.
I don't know.
Inceptor. It goes right back into action. No. Inceptor. High tech. Organic mechanics. Morphing articulation. Full function radio control sense bolt. Inceptor. Roll it, spin it, flip it. You just can't stop it. Inceptor. Battery soul separate from Gear Heresy.
Still dial 0 to call people collect? Stop! It's expensive. Instead, dial 1-800-COLLECT. Dial 1-800-COLLECT so you can give you a call up to 44%. Just dial 1-800-COLLECT. Follow the simple instructions and your call will go through in seconds. Calling home? Save yourself money. 1-800-COLLECT. Dial it today.
Do a deer.
Once upon a time, in a universe parallel to our own, there lived a beautiful princess in a humble castle set deep in an enchanted forest. It was there that Cinderella and her husband, Gary, raised their two charming children, Hansel and Gretel. Every night, Cinderella and Gary would sit next to the fire and watch Hansel and Gretel play on the floor. Life was indeed perfect, which, of course, made everyone in the castle incredibly bored. One particularly ordinarily perfect Tuesday, Cinderella had an incredibly unordinary idea. Cinderella promptly called 1-800-7-DWARVES, a babysitting company which her friend, Snow White, owned and operated.
Thank you for calling 1-800-7-DWARVES. What do you want?
What Grumpy meant to say was,
how can we help you?
We need some babysitters to come to our castle in the woods.
Okay, we'll be there as soon as possible.
Cinderella hung up the phone and warned her children not to open the door for anyone except for the dwarves. Then she and Gary hugged Hansel and Gretel and headed off for the ball.
Yay, ball!
Through different doors. After a few minutes, a knock came at the door. Much to the children's surprise, a girl in a little red cloak came skipping into their house.
Hey, you're not a dwarf.
I'm sorry, you have to leave. I just wanted to play.
Not enough to let anybody except for a dwarf.
You're not a dwarf. Get out. Okay, I guess I need that candy house all by myself.
Candy house, let's go!
So Hansel and Gretel foolishly followed the girl in the little red cloak deep into the forest. Gretel, having been a Girl Scout, left a trail of stinky old goat cheese so that they could find their way home even if they were blinded. Over the river and through the woods, the three children skipped and hopped in circles, triangles, squares, and hexagons until finally they reached a clearing. Little Red, out of breath and in pain, turned to the two children and said,
"How did it if you wish this that way? I suddenly don't feel so good. I'm gonna go lie down. Bye.
Bye."
So off they skipped towards the enticing smells of cinnamon, chocolate, and caramel until at last they reached the candy house. And just before they sunk their teeth into the biggest gingerbread person they had ever seen, it turned its head and yelled,
"We're alive!
Huh? Let me explain."
And explain she did. The gingerbread girl told Hansel and Gretel that when she was still a living girl, she had come across an abandoned house. She went inside and ate three bowls of porridge, accidentally broke a chair, and then was kicked out when the owners of the house, three grizzly bears wearing pants, discovered that she was sleeping in their bed.
After they kicked me out, a little girl in a red cloak helped me up and took me to this candy house where the witch lives here. Invited me in, and before I knew it, I was turned into a gingerbread baby.
Yeah, right.
Hansel and Gretel greedily bit into the gingerbread girl's arms until she had only crumbly cookie shoulders. As she ran away into the forest, she yelled,
"Wait!
Hansel and Gretel ignored the cookie and began to eat a good chunk out of the candy house. Their taste buds were overcome by the sweetness of the walls, windows, and gutters of this strange and delicious house. Suddenly, there came a rickety voice from behind the delectable door.
"Come inside. Kitchen.
crazy cookie. The nice lady is our friend.
So the two foolish children entered the stranger's house, even though they had been warned to stay away. As soon as they entered the sweet-smelling house, the door locked behind them, and some strange magic spell forced their bodies to march and sit in a chair.
I can't move!
I can't either.
You'll
make lovely cookies, Mommy.
Thank you, Dorothy.
Fine.
We're sorry. We wanted to get to you sooner, but we were so hungry.
Now we're all doomed.
That's right. There's nobody to save me. Ha ha ha!
The evil witch's cackle echoed throughout the forest until it was swallowed by darkness. Will the children be saved, or will they be turned into cookies? These questions and more will be answered after these brief commercial messages.
How can there be so?
Carly, Erica, we're ready for our morning report.
Thanks, Hannah. Students
are going
in
chairs, remain above it all.
Mr. Wayne. up wherever I desire. Whirl through a snowstorm or make the autumn leaves whip. But there's one much greater.
I cannot imagine that.
Whether you can imagine it or not, the wall is greater than I. As much as I would puff and I puff, the wall would just stand there. It won't do anything.
So the wall is what I must wear.
She walked on to put down a big stone wall before her.
Mr. Wall, I can hear the brightest thing on earth next to these people on Wednesday.
The pimple, yes, I am. I lived and even when the friend of course the chat best can I be known. Hope is right there, so I think that's what
it is. Tell me, what can I take?
It is not the most to the behold, on my side, I cannot talk. It's a major little bit tougher than mine.
Is a mouse really the greatest thing on earth?
Well, the sun's great, then it's not compact. The crowd of prayers and blessings on the way. The wind is great, but not for the war. And yet, you must marry the wife of
you. Oh, I must marry Max. She walked home very fast, over the hills and valleys, through the forest, under the bridge of the mountain. And at last, she made her over a mile. She went next door and knocked and knocked.
And Stanley opened his door.
Stanley had a great thing on her mind.
Mercy, Lonnie, you gave me such a scare.
Marry me, Stanley, and I will be proud of you as long as I live.
So they did.
And they were cheese.
Whoa, the TV's changing.
Yeah.
and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs, if we have any. Before we begin Act 2, we would like to present you with a unique opportunity. The Ritz Kids Camp is working in association with the Senior Ritz Camp. The Senior Ritz people have been helping out backstage, keeping our young friends quiet and in line. Tomorrow they will be putting on a Ritz original, which was directed and created by Mr. Chris, the choreographer for our camp here. So, before we get started, here's a little scene and a segment from 14 Lines starring the Senior Camp. Tomorrow at 7:30 p.m.